Hello, hi friends and viewers, welcome back. You are watching Highway Ride with Palli Ponnurangam. In this video, we are going to discuss about the traffic volume survey and analysis. Before going to traffic volume survey and analysis, we must understand some basics about the traffic volume. The first one, why we need to conduct the traffic volume survey. The second one, where we need to conduct the traffic volume survey, and the third one is how much time period to require traffic volume survey. First, we should have to understand these three questions, then we will go for the analysis of the traffic volume survey. The first question, the traffic volume survey is the one of the major components of the transportation inventory. Without traffic volume, we cannot say what is the present level of service of the mid-block section or intersection. Without knowing the current situation, we are unable to predict the future situation also, whether it is a mid-block section or it is an intersection. This is the first question answer. The second question, where we need to conduct the traffic volume survey, means there are two places we can able to conduct the traffic volume survey. One is mid-block section, another one is a intersection. The third one is how much time period we must conduct the traffic volume survey, means we must conduct the traffic volume survey at least 16 hour in a day, that is from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m. so that in order to determine the all the factors, that is a peak hour factor, level of service and so on, we can able to predict the mid-block section or intersection. These details are available in IRC 106 1990 in page number 9. The next one, this is a typical section of the road. All the roads have intersections. In between one intersection to another intersection, we have a road. This road, we can say it is a mid-block section. When we are carried out the traffic volume survey in this mid-block section, we can call it as a mid-block volume survey. When we are carrying out the traffic volume in an intersection, we can say it is an intersection traffic volume survey. In this traffic volume survey and analysis, we are going to use or we are going to refer two IRC codes. One is IRC 64-1990, the another IRC is IRC 106-1990. These two IRC codes we are going to refer in this traffic volume survey and analysis purpose. The IRC 64 says guidelines for the capacity of the roads in rural areas. In IRC 106 saying guidelines for capacity of urban roads in plain areas. So in this video we are going to discuss about the urban roads, so we will refer only IRC 106 urban road guidelines. The next one is you can refer IRC 106 1990 in page number 10. The table 1 is available. The table 1 saying recommended PCU factors for various types of vehicles on urban roads. In future, we are going to use for the analysis purpose the PCU factors. We will discuss why we need to use the PCU factors and what is a PCU and all, we'll discuss in later. For now, we must understand what are all the vehicles we are going to count in a traffic volume survey, whether it is a mid-block section or intersection. The vehicles classify into two category. One is fast vehicles, another one is a slow moving vehicles. In fast vehicles, two wheeler or motorcycle, scooter, passenger car, that is a normal car, pickup van, jeep, auto rickshaw, light commercial vehicle, that is LCV, truck, that is a HCV, buses, whether private bus or public bus, agricultural tractor and trailers. So these are all the category we can say it is a fast moving vehicles. Under the slow moving vehicles, cycle, cycle rickshaw, horse driven vehicle, hand cart, these are all called as a slow moving vehicles. Based on the fast moving vehicles, slow moving vehicles, we can refer these things and we can able to know what are the vehicles we are going to count in a traffic volume survey. Based on this table or classification of these vehicles, you can prepare the traffic volume chart or table. In this table, the first column is time. The traffic volume should be conducted each 15 minutes interval. For example, if you are starting the traffic volume in 3:30, you have to count the traffic volume from 3:30 to 3:45 interval. Another 15 minutes, 3:45 to 4 interval, 4 to 4:15 minute interval, 4:15 to 4:30, 4:30 to 4:45, 4:45 to 5 pm. Likewise, you have to split the 15 minutes interval of the traffic volume count. The next column is car, jeep, van as a one category. The next one is a auto rickshaw. The next column is two wheeler. The next column is for analysis purpose, it is easy to understand how much public bus and how much private buses are presently available. The next one is a HCV, high commercial vehicles, LCV, low commercial vehicles, cycle. The last one is others. Others like ambulance, fire engine vehicles, other exclusive vehicles you can refer it. So this is for the traffic volume survey table. You can prepare this table before going to traffic volume count survey. The next one is surveyor requirements. That is a personal requirement for the traffic volume survey. We are going to count the different modes of the vehicles, so we require that so many number of surveyors. In single surveyor, we are unable to predict for the all the different kinds of modes. So we require the n number of supervisors to make a precise traffic volume count. The first one, for two-wheeler, motorcycle or scooter, for any road in a city or rural, the number of two-wheeler or motorcycle is numerous. So we required one supervisor for the exclusively to count the two-wheeler or motorcycles. The next one is passenger car, that is a normal standard car or pickup van or jeep. We required one exclusively surveyor. The next one is for auto rickshaw, it is a one number. Light commercial vehicles, one surveyor. Truck for one surveyor. Buses to calculate public buses and private buses, one surveyor. Cycle and others to calculate for one surveyor. Altogether, we required for one direction. In whether it is a mid block section or it is an intersection, we require 7 number of surveyors. The next one is how to count the traffic volume for the different vehicles in a 15 minutes interval. Before going to enter in this table, for example car, jeep, van, how much number in a 3:30 PM to 3:40 PM, that is a 15 minute interval, what is the car volume, what is the auto volume, what is the two wheeler volume, what is the bus volume, what is the HCV volume, what is the LCV volume. Likewise, each 15 minutes interval we cannot count directly in this table. For this, all the surveyors should use the white papers. You can count the each 15 minutes traffic volume in the different modes by using tally count. Tally count means, for example, you are counting first car, second car, third car, fourth car, in cross line is same fifth car. Likewise, you can calculate each 15 minutes interval traffic volume for different modes. Once completed the traffic volume data collection, we can go for the traffic volume analysis. For this analysis purpose, we are going to use the Excel. So friends, you can open the Excel spreadsheet like this in your computer. Before going to traffic volume data analysis, we have to enter the sum of the basic information about the traffic volume data collected area. First, enter the title Classified Volume Count Survey. Then enter the name of the road where we have taken the traffic volume survey. For example, Rajiv Gandhi Salai, OMR, Chennai IT Corridor. In this road, which direction you have taken the traffic volume data? For example, towards Mathe Kailash. Then mid block. Mid block means in Rajiv Gandhi Salai road where you have taken. That is the exact location of the traffic volume data collected. Karapakkam Apollo Hospital near Aravind Theatre. Then date of the survey is 4th March 2020. Day of the survey is Wednesday. During the survey, the weather condition is sunny. Now prepare the table for the analysis purpose. As we discussed earlier, you can prepare the table like this. The table first column shows the time interval between the 15 minutes. The first row shows the different types of vehicles. Friends, now you can prepare the analysis table in an Excel sheet like this. Friends, after preparation of the analysis table, now you can enter the values which is you are collected during the traffic survey. Like this, you can enter the values, friends, for the every 15 minutes interval for each classification of the vehicles. Once enter these values, now we can go for the calculation. Here, total is there. The total we can calculate one as a vehicle, another in terms of PC. First, we will calculate the total in terms of vehicles for each 15 minutes interval. For each 15 minutes interval vehicles, here summation is there. Select this summation from here to up to others. Enter, you will get this total vehicles in for 330 to 345. This total is all kind of vehicles. So likewise, you can drag for all the 15 minutes interval, you will get the total for all 15 minutes interval vehicles. We will calculate the individual vehicles total. Total in vehicles, select here, summation, auto summation here, select from 332 up to 830 and enter. You will get that 5039 is a total vehicles for car, van, jeep during the survey period. Likewise, you can calculate for the all the vehicles, drag this one, you will get the total vehicles for the individuals. Now we will calculate the percentage for the individual vehicles, that is the composition of the vehicles during the survey period. We know the total vehicles 16850, that is for total vehicles in terms of car, two wheeler, auto, bus, HCV, LCV, like this. All the vehicles total is 16850 vehicles. All vehicles 16850 we are counted during the survey period. For individual vehicles, what is the percentage? For example, the first one is, the first column is car, van, jeep. So now we can calculate the what is the percentage of the car, van, jeep means, select equal to 5039 is the total vehicles of car, van, jeep divided by total vehicles, that is irrespective of all the vehicle 16850, you will get the 30%. So 30% of the vehicle is car, van, jeep. So likewise, we can calculate the other vehicles percentage equal to 447 is a total auto numbers divided by total vehicles 16850, 3% for auto. So likewise, we can calculate for the all the vehicles, the last one is 100%. It should be 100% because we are using divided by this one. Total is 16850 divided by total. So now we are calculated the percentage for the individual vehicles are correct. So this is called the composition of the vehicles. Before going to calculate the total PCU, we need to calculate individual vehicle PCU values. For this, we need to insert one more column for each vehicles. Likewise, you can insert one more column for each vehicles. Now we are inserted one more column for each vehicles to calculate the PCU values for the individual vehicles. Before going to calculate the individual vehicle PCU, first we need to understand what is meant by PCU. PCU means, I already abbreviated, passenger car unit. The definition of PCU is to convert the heterogeneous vehicle into homogeneous. That's mean we are counted during traffic volume survey different vehicle category like car, auto, two wheeler, buses, HCV, LCV, cycle, others. So now we are going to convert the different vehicles into single vehicle, that is called as a passenger car unit. For this conversion, we are going to use the conversion factor value. That conversion factor value, we can say that is called as a PCU factor. That PCU factor value we are not going to assume. We are going to refer by using IRC 106-1990. It is available in page number 10. The table is titled Recommended PCU Factor for Various Types of Vehicles on Urban Roads. This is for equivalent PCU factor. This equivalent PCU factor is available in two way. One is 5% value, another one is a 10% and above value. What is 5% and 10% value? How and where we need to use? This doubt will have everybody. So for this doubt, please read here percentage composition of vehicle type in traffic stream. That's mean we are calculated individual vehicle composition is, so that individual vehicle composition is less than 5%, you can use this values. If the composition is more than 5% and 10% and above, you can use this values. Friends, now we are assigning the PCU factor value for individual vehicle. This PCU factor is based on the proposition of individual vehicle with reference to IRC 106. Now we are going to convert the vehicle into PCU. For example, the first one, car, van, jeep. Here we are having 147 numbers. This 147 numbers multiplied with the PCU factor 1, you can get the PCU value. This PCU value 147, now we are converted as a car. Same like that, you can convert all the vehicle into PCU. Now we are going to convert the auto. For example, auto, first we are having 22 numbers. Multiply with this 22 numbers into PCU factor value 1.2, you will get the PCU value. This PCU value 26.4, we are converted 22 auto into 26.4 cars. Same like that, you can convert all the autos into PCU values. Again, we are going to convert the two wheelers 281 numbers with multiplied by 0.75. This will become as a 211 PCU values. That's mean 281 two wheelers became as a 211 cars. Same like that, you can convert all the two wheelers into PCU values. So likewise, we are going to convert all the vehicle into PCU values here. Friends, now we are converted all the vehicle into PCU values. Now we will calculate the total PCU value. how we are calculated total vehicle here. Same like that, we are going to calculate the total PCU value. For example, you can add the all the PCU value of the different vehicle, car value plus auto value plus two wheeler plus bus government plus bus private plus HCV plus LCV value plus cycle value plus others. So likewise, you can add the all the different vehicle PCU values for the 50 minutes interval. You can get the PCU values. Same like that, you can calculate the all the 50 minutes interval of the PCU values. Now we are calculated total PCU value for the each 50 minutes interval. Next, we will calculate the hourly flow for vehicles as well as PCU. Here we are mentioned hourly flow. The hourly means it is a 450 minutes. So we are having here 50 minutes interval of the traffic volume. The hourly flow, we are going to add the 450 minutes interval of the vehicles. We will get the hourly flow. For example, first here, this is the first 50 minutes, second 50 minutes, third 50 minutes, fourth 50 minutes. So here calculate the first hourly 50 minutes from 450 minutes. So this is called as a hourly volume of from 3:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. The next hour we are going to calculate from 3:45 p.m. to 4:45 p.m. what is the hourly volume. For that, we are going to calculate the first volume here, the second 50 minutes volume here, the third 50 minutes and fourth 50 minutes. So we will get the 5878.9. This is for 3:45 p.m. to 4:45 p.m. traffic volume. So likewise, you can calculate the consecutive traffic hourly volume for the each 50 minutes interval. Same like that, we are going to calculate the hourly flow for the PCU. That is the first PCU 50 minutes, second PCU 50 minutes, the third PCU 50 minutes and fourth PCU 50 minutes. You will get the 2793. It is for 3:30 to 4:30 p.m. You can add the first 50 minutes PCU volume, the second PCU 50 minutes volume, the third PCU 50 minutes volume and fourth 50 minutes PCU volume. This is 3011. This PCU value indicates the hourly flow of the 3:45 p.m. to 4:45 p.m. So likewise, you can calculate the hourly flow of the each 50 minutes interval. Now we will find the hourly flow vehicles and PCU highest value. In this hourly flow vehicles, the highest value is 4015. So you can highlight this one. Same like that, hourly flow PCU highest value is 3698. You can highlight this also. How this 4015 came means we are counted this 450 minutes so that you got it this 4015. Same like that, 3698, how you got it means we are counted this 450 minutes PC value, we got it 3698. This 4015 is the highest hourly volume. So this hourly volume, we can say it is a peak hour value. The peak hour means from 3:30 to 8:30 p.m. traffic count, this value is the highest hourly value. That's mean the highest hourly volume we are calculated from this 450 minutes. This 450 minutes mean we are highlighted here from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. That's mean in this total time 3:30 to 8:30, the highest vehicles traveling in a road is 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. so that this hour is called as a peak hour. Now we will find the some information from this analysis. The first one, peak 50 minutes. What is a peak 50 minutes means? We founded peak hour volume. In this peak hour means there are 450 minutes. In this 450 minutes, which 50 minutes volume is very highest? That 50 minute volume, we can say it is a peak 50 minutes. In vehicle, these are the 450 minutes. In this 450 minutes volume, 1116, that is 1116 is the highest peak 50 minutes volume. Same like that, you can find the peak 50 minutes volume of PCU in this peak hour 3698, means there are 4 50 minutes. In this 4 50 minutes, you can find the highest volume, that is 1037 is a peak 50 minutes PC value. Peak hour volume means already we are highlighted 4015 is a peak hour volume. Then PCU for peak hour 3698 is a peak hour PCU volume. Now we will calculate the peak hour factor based on these values. The first one, based on the formula, volume in PCU during peak hour is 3698 divided by 4 times of highest peak hour 50 minutes volume is 1037, you will get the 0.89. So this is the peak hour factor. That's mean in terms of percentage, 89% of the time is the road is utilizing. I hope everyone is understand how to calculate the peak 50 minutes volumes and how to calculate the peak hour volumes and how to calculate the peak hour factor based on this formula. Now we will calculate the V by C ratio, that is a volume by capacity, or we can call it as a level of service. For this calculation, we required the service volume, that is a V, and capacity of the road is a C. The service volume we are calculated peak 1 hour PCU value, that is a 3698. Capacity we will refer the IRC code. I have assumed the road is 6 lane divided 2 way, so that it is a arterial, that is a urban road, it is a 5400 PCU per hour. So use that 5400 PCU per hour, that is a 6 lane divided arterial street. Use these two value. For example, 3698 is a service volume divided by capacity 5400, you will get the V by C ratio 0.68. or the level of service is 0.68. So the calculated V by C ratio showing 0.68, it's mean the road is right now good condition. When the values reaching 0.8 or 0.9, that means the road required immediate remedial action. Again, the limit is V by C ratio is 1. When the limit is reaching 1 or going to beyond the limit of 1, the road is seems like as a congested. Now we will prepare the some graphical analysis based on the traffic analysis. The first one, vehicle composition. To prepare the graph for vehicle composition, we required some information. The first one, to prepare vehicle composition graph, we required the vehicle composition, so that you can prepare the small table like this here. The table is two rows. The first row shows the classification of the vehicle. The second row shows the composition of the vehicle. The composition of the vehicle taken from the table analysis. Here showing the percentage of the each vehicle taken from here. So that now we will prepare the graph based on these values. For preparation of the graph, you can choose the full rows and columns. Then go for the insert here. In this insert, it's available column, line, pipe, bar, area, scatter, others like this. I am choosing the bar. In this bar chart, I am choosing this one. Now the graph is available. If you want, you can add the data label. For that, right click, add data label. Now it's showing the composition of the each vehicle. It's for the better clarification. So x-axis shows the percentage of the composition, the y-axis showing the different vehicle classification. Now it is easy to understand which vehicle is predominantly going on in our road, means 57% two-wheeler, car, van, jeep is 30%, the remaining is very minimum. The bus private vehicle is 5%, government bus is only 1%. The next one, we will prepare the hourly share of the vehicles along the corridor, that's mean the mode share of the corridor. For this hourly mode share graph preparation, first we need to calculate the individual vehicles hourly volume. For example, from 330 to 430, what is the hourly volume for the individual vehicles, then 430 to 530, then 530 to 630, then 630 to 730, then 730 to 830. Likewise, each hour, what is the volume of individual vehicles we need to prepare in this table. Here already I have calculated all the vehicles' individual hourly volumes. Now I will show you how I calculated this individual hourly volume for the each vehicle. The first one, 330 to 430, car, van, jeep 881. You can refer traffic analysis sheet. Here 330 to 430, car, van, jeep. This 450 minutes you can add, you will get the 881. Same like that, 330 to 430, auto, you can add 450 minutes, you will get the 74. We will check in our table. Here auto showing 74. Again 330 to 430, two wheeler 1236, we will check our traffic analysis sheet. You can add this 450 minutes, 1236 you will get. Same like that, buses for government 37 numbers, so you can check here 37. Likewise, you can calculate all the vehicles' individual hourly volumes before going to prepare the graph sheet. Now we will prepare the graph. First, you have to select the full table, then go for the insert. Insert, here column is available. Select the column, select 2D column. Now you got the graph. In this graph, the x-axis showing the different vehicles. The y-axis showing the flow in vehicle per hour. I want the x-axis, instead of this vehicle, I need time. For this, select here and right click, select data. Here switch row and column is available. You can select this one. Now change it into vehicle to time. You can give OK. Now see, the x-axis is changed as a vehicle into time. Now from the graph we can able to understand each hour which vehicle is majorly traveling. So the green color indicating the two wheeler, the blue colors are indicating car, van, jeep, the remaining small portion of the vehicles are indicating others. From this graph we can able to understand what is the mode share on each hour. The last graph we are going to prepare, volume variation of traffic. For preparation of volume variation traffic, we required each hour total traffic. We already calculated 330 to 430, what is the total hour volume, 430 to 530, what is the total hourly volume, 530 to 630, what is the total, and likewise 630 to 730, 730 to 830, we are calculated total hourly volumes here. Take this total hourly volume. Now you can prepare two columns, one column for time, another column is total hourly volume. Based on this two column, now we are going to prepare the volume variation of traffic graph. You can select this two column, go for insert. Insert, here line is available. Select the line, select 2D line here. Now you receive the graph. Here the x-axis indicating the time, the y-axis indicating flow in PCU per hour. So now we can able to understand each hour what is the traffic on a road. So the majority showing 530 to 630. Obviously in this 530 to 630 is major traffic on a road. Friends, I hope everyone is understand what is the traffic volume survey and analysis. Friends, thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, kindly share, subscribe and press the bell button. Friends, if you want any particular topic on my next video, kindly give your comment and valuable suggestions in comment section.